everybody, and welcome back to another vlog. My name is Claire Carmichael and I'm a third and final year student nurse. Welcome to my channel if you're new, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. This vlog is all about poster presentations or presenting in general and just how to survive that, because I know it's one that most people hate. Most people hate public speaking. It's a common fear that we have as students coming into nursing and thinking, oh my God, I'm gonna have to do presentations because we are assessed on this at university. Whether that's changing with the new standards, I'm not 100%, but at the minute we do poster presentations at Birmingham City University and PowerPoint presentations. So yeah, it is a requirement for us, unfortunately. So hopefully I can give you some tips and advice to survive it, and it's not going to be too scary for you, fingers crossed, but I shall do my best. So my first tip I'm going to give you is a tip that I was given in a workshop that I went to, and they said something that was actually quite obvious, but I didn't really think of it until they mentioned it, which is really strange. So I'm going to pass on this information to you because it really, really helped me. So what they said was, when you yourself are going to watch somebody speak, so at a conference, for example, or even other poster presentations that you're sat watching, you as a person are not judging them on the way they're standing, the way they're speaking. You're not mocking them. You're not doing anything like that. You're probably sat there thinking about your dinner, your workload, who you've got a message, what emails you've got to send, what your girlfriend or boyfriend or kids are doing. Your mind is elsewhere. It's not fully on the talk or conference or presentation. And to be honest, if your attention is fully on it, you're so intrigued in what they're saying, you're not thinking about anything else. You're just listening to the information they're giving, the PowerPoint slides, if there's some of those. You're not judging them as a person. So why are you judging yourself or thinking or overthinking that other people are judging you on this? Because they're not. No one's judging you. No one's gonna mock you. No one's gonna laugh at you if you trip up. In fact, some people won't even notice if you stutter. So it's just quieting those voices, those judgmental voices you've got in your head that shouldn't be there. Completely erase them now. Take them away, get rid of them, erase. So my next tip is all about quieting those anxious voices that might be in your head that's telling you you're going to be rubbish, you're going to fail, you're going to stutter, your heart's going, your breathing's going, you're panicking, you're sweating. This is the big tip for you. Again, from a workshop that I went to, something that was taught to us was to sort of take a minute before you get up there, before you stand there. But it's sort of a tip that you can sort of do as you're standing there as well, quietly in your own head. So firstly, you want to concentrate on your breathing, slow it down, breathe in and breathe out. Just concentrate on that for a second. And then the next thing you want to do is start naming things. Sometimes people name smells that they can smell. They're listening for sounds. So you listen for sounds and you're naming those sounds. So I can hear a bird, I can hear some trucks, I can hear the wind, I can hear some rustling of paper. Start naming things, and whether that's this, what you can smell, what you can hear, what you can see. So maybe I can see a pencil, I can see a chair, I can see a table, there's a clock. Just start naming things, and that just helps you focus and sort of slow everything down and bring you back to the room and just help you calm down. That really, really helps me. It's something I do actually quite a bit when I feel anxious for exams, for example. My first day on placement last week, I did that all the way there because I was excited to start. But at the same time, I was really nervous because I didn't know anyone and I was getting anxious and I could feel myself going. So I started naming things as I was walking and I was concentrating on my breathing. I was naming the cars and everything. And it really did. It massive, massive, massive help for me. I know it works for quite a few students out there. So hopefully, fingers crossed, this tip is going to help you. My second tip is all about that strong power pose. So that by doing the power pose before a presentation or a poster, sometimes in the morning if you're feeling a bit anxious maybe or unconfident, doing the power pose, so the, you know, like the superwoman pose, put your hands on your hips, stand tall, head up, stand proud. Doing that sort of thing apparently releases endorphins and just gives you that little bit of confidence. So before you go on to your presentation, go into the toilet and do this. You don't have to do it in front of everybody, but go into the toilet and do it. Lock yourself in a room somewhere alone, stand there, do your power pose, say, I am brilliant, I'm gonna smash this, I'm gonna do this, I've got this. Talk to yourself, shout out loud if you want to, if it helps. Just do your power pose for a minute and just feel confident, feel good in your own skin, and just smash it. And my last and final tip is probably an obvious one: practice. I know it's sometimes it's hard to fit in, you're going to make excuses because you don't want to practice, you're going to do everything but practice, but you really, really need to practice your poster presentation or your PowerPoint presentation, your talk, whatever you're going to do. You need to practice. So get your friends together, get on FaceTime with people, get on video, stand in your room alone, go through it and through it and through it until you know it inside out and you can recite it and you're dreaming about it, and you can't sleep because you know it. All of those things, just practice daily until you've got it, until you're comfortable with the words that you're speaking. Because I think that's sort of sometimes when we stutter is because we don't know what we're saying, we're not confident in what we're saying, we're thinking about everybody else in the room. And just with all of those tips in place that I've given you, as well as practicing so you know what you're saying, should hopefully ease it, and the words will just flow and you won't need to worry about it. You won't be thinking about, oh my God, what have I got to say? Another thing is if you're going to use flashcards or a script, I use bullet points. I try and avoid full-on scripts because it's too jumbled. I lose my place. I don't like it. I like to one, wing it, and two, if I need a script, I'll bullet point. And those bullet points just keep me right on track. Also with your practicing, if you know that you're going to be doing a presentation in front of your class, get a group of you together and practice in front of each other. I think that's a really good way to do it as well. So meet up at uni, find a room, see if there's anywhere you can go. If you've got a library, sometimes they have like the little quiet rooms that you can all go in and just stand in front of each other and practice your presentation in front of each other, because the more you do that, the more you're going to get used to it and you won't feel as bad when you're in the room in front of all these people. I think that's a good tip, I hope, and yeah, hopefully it'll help you out. And another thing I was just going to add there, sorry, I know I said it was the end of the video, I've got just one more little thing, just because I mentioned stuttering. So this tip is for stuttering. Apparently tongue twisters help with stuttering when you present. I don't know the facts and figures and research behind it, but apparently it does. So try a tongue twister as well before you get up there and start talking. But apparently it just gets the muscles in your tongue going, something like that. And it just really helps with your speech. So yeah, so hopefully the tongue twisters will really, really help you. If they don't, I'm really, really sorry. But it's just another tip again that I've been given throughout a workshop. And hopefully all of these are going to be amazing and help you out. So that is it from me. I hope I've given you some help, some advice, some tips to survive your poster presentations. I know it's not nice. I know it can be really nerve-wracking. So I'm really hoping that these really help you. Let me know in the comments below if there's something else that you do, if these tips work for you, if there's anything else that you do that works for you that maybe I haven't mentioned, please comment below so that someone else can see it and help each other out. And just go for it. Good luck, and you're gonna smash it.